ಬಜೆಟ್ ಭಾಷಣವನ್ನು ಓದಲು ಆರಂಭಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಪಿಯೂಷ್ ಗೋಯಲ್.
मैडम स्पीकर, मैं वर्ष 2019-20 के लिए भारत सरकार के अनुमानित प्रतियां और व्यय का वितरण प्रस्तुत करने के लिए आपसे अनुमति लेते हैं. मैडम स्पीकर, आई राइज टू प्रेजेंट द इंटरिम बजट फॉर द ईयर 2019-2020. पार्ट ए, I am deeply conscious of the absence of Shri Arun Jaitley today. I am sure the House joins me in wishing Shri Jaitley speedy recovery, good health, and a long life in the service of the nation. Madam Speaker, the people of India gave a strong mandate to our government. Under the visionary leadership of Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi, we are given the most decisive, stable and clean government and have undertaken transformational structural reforms. We have reversed the policy paralysis engulfing the nation and have restored the image of the country. Is sarkar ki uplabdhi rahi ki humne सोच को बदलने के अथक प्रयास करे और देश के आत्मविश्वास को बढ़ाया. आई कैन प्राउडली से दैट इंडिया इज सॉलिडली बैक ऑन ट्रैक एंड मार्चिंग टुवर्ड्स ग्रोथ एंड प्रोस्पेरिटी. वी हैव प्रिपेयर्ड द फाउंडेशन फॉर सस्टेनेबल ग्रोथ, प्रोग्रेस एंड बेटर क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ. We are moving towards realizing a new India by 2022. When we celebrate 75 years of independence, an India which is clean and healthy, where everybody would have a house with universal access to toilets, water, electricity, where farmers' income would have doubled. Get ample opportunity to fulfill their dreams. An India free from terrorism, communalism, casteism, corruption and nepotism. State of the economy. Madam Speaker, the last 5 years have seen India being universally recognized as a bright spot of the global economy. The country witnessed its best phase of macroeconomic stability during this period. We are the fastest growing major economy in the world today, with an average GDP growth higher during the last 5 years, higher than the growth achieved by any government since economic reforms began. From being the 11th largest economy in the world in 2013-14, we are today the 6th largest in the world. Besides generating high growth rate, we contained double digit inflation and restored fiscal balance. Inflation is a hidden tax and an unfair tax on the poor and the middle class. The average rate of inflation during 2009-2014 was a back-breaking 10.1%. The then Prime Minister admitted as much when he said, and I quote, "We have also not been as successful in controlling persistent inflation as we would have wished. This is primarily because food inflation has increased," unquote. Iske vipreet, hamari sarkar ne kamar tod mehngai ki kamar hi tod di. We brought down average inflation to 4.6%, which is lower than the inflation during the tenure of any other government. In fact, inflation in December 2018, mengai December 2018 mein sirf 2.19% par ghat kar aa gayi. If we had not controlled inflation, our families would have been spending 35% to 40% more today on basic necessities such as food, travel, consumer durables, housing. Aap kalpana kariye 35-40% adhik kharcha hota har parivar ka agar humne is mehngai pe lagam nahi lagayi. From the high of almost 6% 7 years ago, the fiscal deficit has been brought down to 3.4% in the revised estimate of 2018-19. The current account deficit, against a high of 5.6% 6 years ago, is likely to be only 2.5% of GDP this year. We contained the fiscal deficit, notwithstanding the Finance Commission's recommendations, increasing the share of the states from 32% to 42% in central taxes, which we accepted in the true spirit of cooperative federalism, thereby transferring significantly higher amounts to the states. Due to a stable and predictable regulatory regime, a growing economy and strong fundamentals, India could attract massive amount of foreign direct investment during the last 5 years. As much as $239 billion was received as FDI. This period also witnessed a rapid liberalization of the FDI policy, allowing most FDI to come through the automatic route. Madam Speaker, the last 5 years have witnessed a wave of next generation structural reforms, which have set the stage for decades of high growth. We have undertaken path-breaking structural reforms by introducing the goods and services tax and other taxation reforms. Banking reforms and insolvency and bankruptcy code. The period of 2008 to 2014 will be remembered as a period of aggressive credit growth, and as per RBI, the primary reason for a spurt in non-performing loans and stressed assets. Outstanding loans of public sector banks ballooned from 18 lakh crore to 52 lakh crore during this period. Many projects were started that could either not be completed or had low capacity utilization, resulting in their inability to pay back these loans. They were high stressed and non-performing assets amounting to rupees 5.4 lakh crore in 2014, even though they were not being recognized as NPA at that point of time. Many more were hidden through restructuring or otherwise, which were discovered during the asset quality reviews and inspections carried out since 2015. Hamare sarkar mein ye dam tha ki hum Reserve Bank of India ko kahein ke ye sabhi loans ko dekhe aur bankon ki sahi sthiti desh ke samne rakhe. We put a stop to such questionable practices and stop the culture of phone banking. The 4 hours approach of recognition, resolution, recapitalization and reforms have been followed. A number of measures have been implemented to ensure clean banking. Through a transparent and accountable process, we recognize these NPAs. The Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code has institutionalized a resolution-friendly mechanism which is helping in recovery of non-performing loans while preserving the underlying businesses and jobs. Pehle sirf chote businessmen par ऋण वापस करने का दबाव रहता था और अब बड़े बिजनेसमैन को भी ऋण की चिंता होती है, केवल बैंक को नहीं होती. बट नाउ डिफॉल्टिंग मैनेजमेंट्स आर आइदर पेइंग और एग्जिटिंग देयर बिजनेसेस. एन अमाउंट ऑफ क्लोज टू 3 लाख करोड़ has already been recovered in favor of banks and creditors. To restore the health of public sector banks, recapitalization has been done with an investment of 2.6 lakh crore rupees. Amalgamation of banks has also been done to reap the benefits of economies of scale, improved access to capital, and to cover a larger geographical spread. हाल ही में कल हम सबको खुशखबरी मिली कि इन सब अथक प्रयासों के कारण तीन बैंक, बैंक ऑफ इंडिया, बैंक ऑफ महाराष्ट्र एंड ओरिएंटल बैंक ऑफ कॉमर्स, इन तीनों से पीसीए की रिस्ट्रिक्शंस भी अब हटा दी गई हैं। और मुझे पूरा विश्वास है जिस गति से बैंकिंग में सुधार हुआ है, बाकी सब बैंक्स भी बहुत तेज गति से इस व्यवस्था से निकल के फिर एक बार जोर से तेजी से बैंकिंग व्यवस्था में आ जाएंगे। स्टेप्स अगेंस्ट करप्शन, वी हैव अशर्ड इन अ न्यू एरिया ऑफ ट्रांसपेरेंसी। हमने भ्रष्टाचार मुक्त सरकार चलाई। द रियल एस्टेट रेगुलेशन एंड डेवलपमेंट एक्ट 2016 रेरा and Benami Transaction Prohibition Act are helping to bring transparency in the real estate sector. The Fugitive Economic Offenders Act 2018 will help confiscate and dispose of the assets of economic offenders who escape the jurisdiction of the laws in India. Additionally, we conducted transparent auction of natural resources, including coal and spectrum. We have walked the talk. Swachhata, as a tribute to Mahatma Gandhi, whose 150th birth anniversary we are celebrating in 2019, our government initiated the world's largest behavioral change movement with the Swachh Bharat Mission. India has achieved over 98% rural sanitation coverage and as many as 5,45,000 villages have been declared open defecation free. It is a holistic program and has succeeded in changing the mindset of our people. Vyapak Jan Bhagidari se logon ne ise ek sarkari yojana se rashtriya andolan bana diya hai. Swachh Bharat Abhiyan ki safalta ke liye main desh 130 crore जनता का तहे दिल से धन्यवाद करता हूं जिन्होंने इसे पूरे हृदय से अपनाया. गरीब पिछड़ा वर्ग, देश के संसाधनों पर पहला अधिकार गरीबों का है. सरकार ने मौजूदा आरक्षण जो कि एससी एसटी अन्य पिछड़े वर्ग के लिए है उसको पूरी तरीके से पूर्ण रूप से बरकरार रखते हुए गरीबों के लिए भी अब शैक्षणिक संस्थानों में और सरकारी नौकरियों में 10% का आरक्षण सुनिश्चित किया है. इन संस्थानों में औसतन 25% अतिरिक्त सीट्स, लगभग 2 लाख सीट्स उपलब्ध कराई जाएंगी जिससे किसी भी वर्ग के लिए वर्तमान में उपलब्ध आरक्षित सीट्स में कोई कभी कमी ना आए. गरीबों और मध्यम वर्ग के परिवारों को सस्ते दाम पर अनाज उपलब्ध कराने के लिए वर्ष 2018-19 में लगभग 1,70,000 करोड़ रुपए का व्यय किया गया जो वर्ष 2013-14 के खर्च के मुकाबले लगभग 2 गुना है. 13-14 में मात्र 92 करोड़ रुपए लगभग खर्च हुए थे. हमने यह सुनिश्चित किया कि अनाज सबको मिले और किसी को भूखे पेट नहीं सोना पड़े. मनरेगा के लिए भी बजट एस्टिमेट 2019-20 में 60,000 करोड़ का आवंटन किया जा रहा है. जरूरत पड़ने पर और भी धनराशि उपलब्ध करा दी जाएगी. We have worked to bridge the urban-rural divide in the country. Honorable members in this August House, many of whom are from rural areas, will agree that several times in the past, only empty promises have been made to the people living in our villages. During the last 5 years, we have undertaken targeted expenditure to improve their quality of life in all its dimensions.